Hey everyone, I'm Hayley and welcome back to What the Film School. In today's video, I'm going to talk about student films. So today I want to talk about both the positives and the negatives of student films, why we need to make them in the first place, and how it's going to affect you if you go to film school and if you don't go to film school. Student films pretty much can be considered any film that you'd be making while you're in film school, even if you're still in high school as well. These can also be referred to as amateur films, since obviously you're not going to be having a high budget, you're not going to be having a large cast and crew, and you're going to be keeping things pretty limited to just what your resources are either at school or outside of school as well. So to start off with some of the best things about making student films, number one, it's just really great experience. If you're really trying to work on set, you really want to do more of that hands-on stuff, working on student films is the best way to get your hands dirty and try everything. When I was in film school, I had a film production class that I was a part of, and it was a responsibility for everyone in the crew to work on everybody else's set, and you had to switch roles for each one. But I actually was able to do producing, assistant directing, I got to set up lights, I got to set up sound equipment, and I directed some myself. It's pretty great that you're able to basically try every department, because in the real world, if you're going to work on a professional set, more than likely you're just going to be working as a PA, unless you're interested in doing something specific like sound or lighting. And obviously for things as big as directing on a professional set, you can't really jump into that immediately. You can shadow a director or be an assistant to a director, but to actually get up to that level is going to take quite some time. For student films, the second best thing is that you get to wear many hats. So basically if you want to direct, you can direct as many student films as you want. No one's going to stop you. Third best thing about student films is that you will get a lot of discounts because you will be using the student film excuse. Basically, people often have pity on students because they know that their budgets are quite tight, they don't have a lot of money to spend on their locations or on their food budgets or on their actors. Often you'll find some retailers give you discounts on the location costs, sometimes you'll get discounts on equipment rentals. Definitely always ask if you're a student in a high school or in film school, even if you're just considering yourself a student filmmaker, see what discounts you'll have available to you and who can help you out. The fourth best thing about student films is that they're great for building up your portfolio as well. So the better and better that you get at making student films, obviously the more people you can have come work with you because you're meeting people on set, you're networking, you're making friends, it's a really great environment for that, and you're also making yourself look better because it shows that you're really passionate about something, and you can start building up your reel of projects that you worked on, and you can show that to future employers, or even put that online if you want to get some exposure too. And then the fifth best thing about student films is that you can submit them to a lot of different festivals. I will link some student film festivals down below. I had applied to a couple back in my day. Definitely if you're looking to get some more exposure for yourself and break into the film production world, submitting your student films to festivals is going to be the best way to get yourself noticed and to also just continue to network with people. Because a lot of people who attend festivals, even if they don't win something, they're still there to network and they're still there to get some extra exposure, meet some friends, and maybe start making some new movies. So unfortunately there are some negatives about student films. The first one being that people kind of look down on student filmmakers because it doesn't really make you seem as legitimate if you're just shooting a student film because people will automatically assume that it's going to be low quality. But it is a phase that everybody has to go through, because I don't think that there are a lot of filmmakers out there that didn't go through the student film phase. The second negative thing about student films, again, is that you're going to have very limited resources, very limited access to the really big equipment, unless somehow you miraculously have a huge budget. But assuming in this instance your budget is going to be pretty small for the student film, then you're not going to be able to get as much as you want. Sometimes you have to sacrifice things from your script because you just can't afford to do them, which is kind of a shame. The third negative thing about student films, and I haven't run into this problem as much, but I know some people have, is that usually since your budget is going to be lower, you can't really afford to pay your actors anything or very little. Sometimes actors might not want to work with students or on a student film because they're not going to get paid for it. But again, you can submit their footage for their reel if they're looking to build up that experience, then that's going to be great for them. The fourth negative thing about student films, again, is that there's often not very much reward from them. I actually wasn't seeing any of the finished products for the films I was working on. That's a little disappointing because you spend a lot of long hours working on student films, and to not get really anything out of it aside from the experience can be a little frustrating at times, but again, that's kind of the nature of student films. And finally, the fifth negative thing about student films is that there's always going to be that film student look to your movie. No matter how much equipment you get, no matter how hard you try, something is going to feel a little bit low budget about it still, and it's really hard to break away from that. So basically, student films are kind of a necessary evil. It's more of just being kind of an amateur filmmaker. This is the first phase before you can actually start working on some more professional shoots. I had a lot of great memories from working on my friend's student sets when I was back in film school. Again though, if you're not in film school or if you're trying to get into film school, the best suggestion that I have for you, people are always looking to hire extra hands on set, even if it's professional or if it's just a student film. So definitely look around online, on Facebook as well. Maybe you live near a university that has a film program. You can always try reaching out to the professors or the students there to see if they need extra help on the weekends. To sum things up, I honestly do think making student films is actually a really important part of your career. Again, it's gonna be the first part of you getting that extra experience because it's very hard, like I had mentioned, to get all of that hands-on experience like that when you're working as a PA on set because you can't really jump into every single department and ask people what they're doing. But on a student film, you're basically mocking what a professional set looks like. So you're able to see every role, how they're working together, what the protocol and the etiquette is of working on set, all the lingo. I actually was on a student set last weekend, so I'm gonna be posting some footage and behind the scenes clips from that very soon. So keep an eye out for that. If you have any questions about working on student sets, what you feel about it, if you hate it or if you love it, if you've already been working on student films, leave the comments down below. Let me know what you think. Ask any questions. Also go check below for all my social media on Instagram and Twitter, What the Film School and WT Film School. And also be sure to check out my blog posts on WTFilmSchool.com. If you haven't subscribed already, be sure to click the subscribe button and also be sure to click the bell notification button so you'll be updated anytime I post a video. Thanks so much for watching. I'll see you guys again soon. Bye!